What's going on, guys? The Inhuman Beatdown. I'm here with a quick sort of question kind of thing. So it comes without a doubt that we're almost to the end of the Fate Extra Let's Play. Yes, we are that close to the ending. It should come as no surprise to anyone. I've literally almost got the entire thing filled up. I'm 2 weeks ahead of recording. A lot of recording. Anyways, that's not the point here. The question is now, and there is a reason I wanted to discuss this. It's a big question I've been dawning in my head for quite some time, and I want to hear your kind of... Let me just explain. For all of those who don't know what Fate Extra is, you should go watch my Let's Play of it. Seriously, I'm almost done with it. 70-some parts right now. Go watch. Anyways, Fate Extra was an RPG that was taken from the Fate series, which originated as a visual novel for Fate Stay Night. Now, let's get all of that out of the way. I'm going on the premise that if you're watching this video, you know what Fate Extra is, and you've been watching my playthrough, hopefully. If you haven't, go watch it. I don't think I can hammer that in enough. Anyways. Now, Fate Extra wasn't the last RPG game that we received based upon the Fate license. It got a sequel. That was Fate Extra Triple C. Fate Extra Triple C did several things amazingly that Fate Extra did not, including a more expansive story with several different endings, including one for each of your servants, one for a basic route, two other routes that I won't mention because they're spoilerish, and whatnot. The basic premise of Fate Extra Triple C is that a rogue AI known as BB looks an awful like Sakura. I don't know why. Don't ask. Anyways, is taking control of, I think, the Moon Cell, or at least this division of it, and has trapped all the Masters inside of it. So it's up to you and your servant to go in there and beat the shit out of her while refighting some old familiar faces. It does reuse a lot of the Masters, but introduces a lot of the new ones, and the plot will explain why, basically. But we're not fighting just all of the old Masters. In fact, there's quite a few new ones in here, including for a fact that now the servant roster has been bumped up from three, the original three being Saber, Archer, and Caster, has now been bumped up to one more, everyone's favorite egotistical, the King of Heroes, Gilgamesh. No doubt everyone's gonna play as him. Anyways. So, this did several things. The same kind of combat is there, the rock, paper, scissors format, and I hesitate to use that because it's not really. Rock, paper, scissors requires luck. This requires strategy and analysis while also using skills to overcome those. Anyways. But also features an auto button for combat now. Don't know the buttons and don't want to just randomly guess? Hit this button, it'll also automatically fill in the right answers for other skills, such as if an opponent is using guard for one attack, hitting the auto button will fill in the blank ones with random abilities, and you'll also break on that one. It's a real simple thing if you just want to get by and you can probably kill something with one hit. Anyways, so the story is much more expansive, and the RPG is better, sort of, and new characters! You may be asking yourself, Beatdown, why are you asking this question? We don't give a fuck! Why don't you just play it? Well, therein comes the question. You've probably noticed throughout this entire video, Fate Extra Triple C is in total Japanese. It was never released outside of Japan, unfortunately. For whatever reason. And as far as I know, they have no intentions of releasing it, because Japan are assholes like that. More specific companies like Bandai Namco. Anyways. So, now currently I go to several places that I'm waiting on. Xeno Translations is actually working on translating the game, like complete patch translation, but there's still a long, long way from completing it, and I love this game. Now, another I've been following, and I don't remember their thing to save my life, but right now they're actually keeping a catalog of all the dialogue translated, and here's my question for you. If I were to do a Let's Play of this game, would you want me to do it using this translation guide to read off all the dialogue. Keep in mind, unfortunately, this is a pretty good translation of it. There's no broken English or anything like that. But it's not complete. It goes almost to the end of the game, but currently not. Not that I plan on doing this Let's Play anytime soon, of course. And it only follows one route, which is the route I would probably take anyway, so it all works out in the end. Anyways, so that's my question to you guys. If and when I do Fate Extra Triple C, would you like me to have a no-commentary run of it, just nothing? You are confused throughout the entire thing. I know, it sounds like a great option. Or would you want me to try and scramble using this translation to read off what it is? And it's pretty good. I've gotten to the point where I can understand each sentences as it keeps going on, mainly due to the fact of periods. Periods are a godsend. And God, Japan uses periods. Anyways, I'll let that sink in for a while, and until then, I'll catch you all later. Asta.